good day to all of you.
So we have mathematical induction. Mathematical induction is a method of proving theorems and mathematical conjectures. Mathematical induction is also considered as the formal for the valid proof.
We have three steps in mathematical induction. The first step in mathematical induction is the basis step. On the basis step, we show that the conjecture is true when n is equal to 1. The next step is the inductive step. On the inductive step, we assume that the conjecture is true when n is equal to any number. Then, we prove that it is also true when n is equal to the succeeding number. And the last one is the conclusion. In the conclusion, we conclude that the conjecture is true for all natural numbers. Here is an example of a divisibility statement. Prove that 8 divides 9n minus 1. So, this 9n minus 1 is what we call the conjecture, or the P of n. So we need to prove that 9n minus 1 is divisible by 8. So by doing that, we need to follow the steps in mathematical induction. The first step is the basis step, where we will show that 9 raised to n minus 1 is divisible by 8 when n is equal to 1. So we will just substitute n by 1. We have 9 raised to 1 minus 1. We have 8. And of course, 8 divides 8. So our statement is true. For our second step, we need to do two things. The first one is we need to show that 9 raised to n minus 1 is divisible by 8 for any number k. So we'll just let n be equal to k. So it will become 9 raised to k minus 1 is divisible by 8. And this will be our induction hypothesis. Or assumption. So the next thing that we need to do is we need to show that this conjecture is true for the number after k. We will just replace n by k plus 1. 9k plus 1 minus 1. This is equal to 9 raised to k times 9 raised to 1 minus 1. Let this be equal to 8 plus 1. 9 is k times 8 plus 1 minus 1. So distributive property, we have 9 raised to k times 8 plus 9 is k minus 1. So according to our assumption, this is divisible by 8. This is our assumption. And this is also divisible by 8. Because any number multiplied by 8 is divisible by 8. So what we have shown is that for all natural numbers, conjecture, which is 8 divides 9 raised to n minus 1, is true. For our second example, we have proved that 3 divides n cubed minus n. So for our basic step, we just need to let n be equal to 1. And then substitute it, we have 1 base of 3 minus n. Substitute it in our conjecture, which is this. So we have 1 minus 1, 0, and 3 divides 0. For our second step, the first thing that we need to do is let n be equal to any number k. Then we will make our assumption that 3 divides k cubed minus k. So the next thing that we need to do is let n be equal to the number after k. So we substitute it to the conjecture. We have k plus 1 cubed minus k plus 1. So let us expand the trinomial. We have k cubed plus 3k squared plus 3k plus 1. So this is equal to this. And then distribute the negative k minus 1. Before simplifying, we need to just check if our assumption is already in this expression. So our assumption is k cubed minus k. So we need to find if k cubed minus k is already in this expression. So we have k cubed here and we have negative k. So we would just put it together and then we would cancel this. Then we would decompose in any way of using factoring. This is divisible by 3 based on our assumption, and this is also divisible by 3, because any number multiplied by 3 is divisible by 3. For all natural numbers, the conjecture that 3 divides n cubed minus n is true. Thank you very much for watching my video. If you like it, please leave a comment or subscribe to my channel.